Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Jane Jennings. It's hard to imagine a time without some form of wearable technology. From the creation of pocket watches and hearing aids to fitness trackers and Bluetooth headsets, it's part of our everyday lives. Today, wearable technology is also being used to research the health of astronauts aboard the International Space Station. Spaceflight affects body temperature regulation and daily rhythms due to the absence of convection and changes in cardiovascular and metabolic systems. The European Space Agency's T-Mini is a non-invasive headband monitor that measures core body temperature to examine how the body thermoregulates during spaceflight. Spaceflight can also disrupt sleep-wake patterns. The ActiWatch Spectrum, a wrist-worn device, measures motion and ambient light to monitor sleep quality and duration. Earlier missions showed astronauts slept less during spaceflight. The ActiWatch SleepLong study linked sleep deficiencies to changes in circadian rhythms caused by ambient light. Follow-up studies are testing lighting systems to help astronauts maintain healthy sleep cycles.
Soyuz running up to full power, and we have liftoff.
The unpiloted Progress 90 spacecraft launched from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan at 7:22 a.m. Eastern Time on Thursday, carrying nearly 3 tons of food, fuel, and supplies to the Expedition 72 crew aboard the space station. After a 2-day in-orbit journey to the station, the spacecraft is expected to dock autonomously to the space-facing port of the orbiting laboratory's Poisk module at 9:35 a.m. Saturday, November 23rd. The Progress 90 spacecraft will remain docked at the station for approximately 6 months before departing for a re-entry into Earth's atmosphere to dispose of trash loaded by the crew. Who said space science and art can't coexist? NASA astronaut Don Pettit gives us a glimpse into an awe-inspiring sight. Conducting what is called the science of opportunity, NASA astronaut Don Pettit recently viewed thin wafers of ice under polarized filters on the International Space Station to better understand the behaviors of freezing water under microgravity conditions without gravitational buoyancy. These ice wafers were photographed between a polarized filter and a laptop display used to eliminate and cross-polarize the thin ice, giving a colorful art-like image highlighting the fragmented crystals. You can keep up with the current crew on station as well as the science by following us on social media at @astro_pettit, @NASA_astronauts, @space_station, and @ISS_research. And that's Space to Ground for now. Thank you so much for watching.